Hey guys, welcome back. It's been a while since I did a sit-down video, but I thought today would be a great day since it's raining outside and it's not the best time to go out to vlog. And I know you've already seen quite a lot of my vlogs, so I thought today I'd do a sit-down video. And since I've been talking all the time about secondhand shopping and thrifting and all of these great things about being a little bit more sustainable when it comes to our fashion choices, I thought I'd sit down with you and talk to you about my best secondhand or thrifted finds. And I've got three categories that I want to talk about. There's shoes, there's bags, and of course, there's clothes. Now, I do have a lot of thrifted treasures, but I didn't want to make this video too long, so I whittled them down to 5 items per category. So I think I will start off with my shoe collection, my shoe finds. And I think one of the most exciting ones that I have found are these boots. Okay, don't worry, I'll do a close-up of these items for you guys so you can see it. Yeah, these boots I got from the Salvo stores in Minchinbury, and they are Miu Miu boots. Yes, you heard that right. Miu Miu boots. And what's even better than that is that they are in pristine condition. Well, not really pristine, because you can tell from the soles that they've been used and they've been loved. I got them for $6, the whole pair. There's nothing wrong with the leathers. If anything, I just need them to be resoled. But yeah, it's beautiful. Like, even the inside is made of pure leather. It's beautiful. So yeah, so $6 for those. That was like a real win when I saw that. It was like in the middle of summer, but I was like, I don't care, I'm gonna get these boots and wait until winter when I can wear them. Speaking of boots, these are the next two things that I got, and I believe this were from the Vinnie's store on King Street in Newtown. These are by Bally, and it is so in today, the square toe. This isn't very square toe, it's still a little bit more pointy, but it's still square toed as opposed to my other super pointy boots. So yeah, these were by Bally, and I believe I paid, and I can see it at the bottom, $20. So it's a little bit more expensive than my Miu Miu ones, but these are ones that I would be able to use to work pretty much daily, especially when the colder months come. It's made in Italy. It's 100% leather. It says that the size is 38 EU or 7.5 US. I'm usually a 37 EU, which translates to 6.5 US. So I don't know what's up with that the sizing, but yeah, I got these. Pretty. Okay. And you would have seen in a few of my Instagram posts, this pair come up quite often. These are my Doc Martens, Voss, I believe is what they are called, Voss sandals. If I can find it, yeah, Voss sandals, UK4. So these, well, with the chunky sandals being quite a trend, but I did like that this came in neutral color, so it was pretty easy to pair them with anything. I do have the Blair sandals in, I think it's in powder blue. It's in really light blue, but I'm going to sell that off because I don't really use it. So, and I think this were a little bit expensive. I got them for, I believe, $50 plus shipping, because they were from eBay. Next up is another find. I believe this were from the Giant Salvo stores in Tempe near IKEA. These are by Karen Millen. And excuse, there's some foot powder in there because I've been using them for work. They've got a mid-high heel, which is comfortable enough for me to wear because I'm not really a heel person. So this is 37.5, and I just love the detail in the front and how it's such a pointed toe. It looks so sexy. Whether you're wearing a skirt or work trousers, it's so beautiful. And it's a beautiful rich chocolate brown that goes with pretty much anything. Like in a at a distance, it even looks like it's black. Okay, I think we're up to the final shoe now, and this is by Mimco. It came in a dust bag. I did buy that. Oh, sorry, the Catamaran shoes were $20 from Salvo stores, but they are really beautiful. Now, these Mimco shoes are a little bit more expensive because they are barely used. The owner said that it was used once to attend a wedding, and you can tell from the use of the soles that she isn't lying. And what I loved about this is the different textures of leather that was used on this. This is 100% leather upper and leather lining and leather sole. This is made in China. And excuse me, but I'm just going to say, to show you what the shoe says at the bottom. I want to go, let's block my face. I want to go, it says there at the bottom. And then on the other bottom, it says, take me where. I think they meant to say take me anywhere though. Okay, these are by Mimco, which is a very popular brand here in Australia. And look at like the heel height is also very nice. And it's like textured, sort of like snakeskin, faux croc, I'm not sure. There's also a little bit of suede on there. So just love this pair. Size 37, barely used. I paid a lot more for this. This was $35 plus shipping, so I paid almost like $52 for this. But these pair go for like $200, so I'm fine with that. My second hand is never just about thrift. I always try to look at the quality as well. Okay. Now let's go to the next category, and this is bags. So, I think one of the best finds that I've had is this Gucci Messenger bag, okay, that I got from Newton Vintage, and I believe I paid $39 for this, and it is, it's authentic. It's like, I looked it up. I was like, when I was in the store, I was on my phone and looking up this, and I put the serial number and the actual bag, this exact bag, came up. So I was like, I'm buying that, $39 for a Gucci Messenger bag. Yeah. And I remember going home to the Philippines and going to Green Hills, where they sell a lot of replica items. And I always wondered why the salespeople were like flocking onto me. And then one of the girls said that she remembered me passing by because I was wearing a original Gucci amongst the many replicas that they had over there. So this is pretty much like an everyday bag when I'm going out, like running errands and stuff, because it's just easy to put on. It's crossbody, so that was perfect. This next one is a bag that if you know, you know. There is nothing about it that would tell you what brand it is unless you look closely, and there you will see it is a Loewe bag. Right? Can you see that label right in the front? It's a beautiful leather. It's vintage. I actually got this from the Kirribilli markets. And it was being sold by an old French lady. She was probably in her like mid-70s, early 80s. And they were trying to get rid of a lot of their things in their house. And so I was looking at some of the bags, and this one caught my eye. I didn't even know that it was Loewe when I saw it at first. You can tell with the hardware there, it also says Loewe. But what got to me was, so I was looking at it, I was like thinking, oh, it's probably not fake. And then I found this in the pocket. And in here as well is a little card that tells you what the bag is. I don't know if you can actually see what's written on there. Yep. So that little card tells you what the bag is. And she sold it to me for $50, saying that it costs her over $1,000 to get before. So I do have two Loewe bags, but they are both replica bags that I got secondhand off of the Facebook marketplace. So I didn't I do love those two bags. One is the puzzle bag in navy, and then the other one is the gate bag. They're beautiful. They're the contemporary designs that are out currently, but I don't really want to put out a replica item as a some of my best buys, although I do use those quite a lot. And if I didn't mind that too much, those definitely would be in my best buys. But this one I really like because it's very understated. It doesn't really scream I'm a branded bag. And I've used this on both of the interviews that I went to for my current job, and I feel like it's a lucky bag because I did get the job. Okay. Next. Yeah, yes, all of my bags are kept in dust bags. This one is probably one of my most coveted bags. This is my Louis Vuitton Alma, and this is a 24 year old bag now, because this was made in 1996, based off of the serial number that's inside. And you can tell by how honeyed the patina is on the bachetta, and it's gorgeous. I put a silk scarf on it to like sort of break the monotony of the colors, but this is just, I mean, it's gorgeous. I bring it out when I have some fancy places to go to, like my birthday if there's a special occasion, but it's not something that I use every day, because it's vintage, and it looks pretty old. Like, if you look very closely at, let's say, the handles, you can really tell that it's been loved. So I also love it, and I make sure that I don't really use it too much so that it just stays beautiful. I got this off of eBay from a reputable seller from Japan. Now, in Japan, it is illegal to sell counterfeit products, so I'm fairly sure, and it's been authenticated, that this is the real deal. And I paid, if I can just go very quickly onto my eBay, I will tell you exactly how much I paid for this. Now, the Alma bags go for a lot of money, I will say that. Just go and find it. Here we go. I paid a total of $235 for this bag, and it's in really good condition. So there's some like watermarks on it, but that's just out of use. And these bags, usually when I go on, let's say, the Facebook marketplace for something of this like quality, it would have cost me something between $600 to $800, and I paid $235 including the shipping to here. So that's maybe one thing that you might want to look at if you're looking for some designer items, just to go on eBay. But make sure that you look at who the seller is, their ratings, their reviews, and like authenticity and all that. Okay, that's that. I have another one that is also from a Japanese seller, from eBay, and I have this in their blue label, so that might give you an idea of what it is. It's a very big, sort of like, this could actually be an overnight bag, because it's a small, well, relatively small duffel bag, but it's big enough to fit like a toiletry bag and a change of clothes. So this is my Burberry, sort of, it's like a camera bag. I can smell how vintage it is. Okay, this Burberry bag I got off of eBay as well. I think I paid a little bit more for this, something like $300. Let me just go ahead and check that. $312, including the postage. This is the Burberry Nova Check shoulder bag, beige canvas with authentication, SA2231. Okay, so it's a little bit more. Honestly, haven't really used this much unless I'm just going overnight somewhere, let's say a hotel where I don't have to bring towels and extra stuff, so things like that, or when I go and take some pictures outside. But it's, I mean, you can tell it's beautiful, right? It's got this really thick strap that you can elongate, so really love this. Another one that I also got from, is that all of it? 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, so the last one is also a designer. As I was saying, I also have a Burberry Blue Label bag, which is a much newer version. But for those of you who don't know, Burberry used to exclusively sell their Blue Label in Japan for the younger generation, because Burberry kind of has that feel of like sort of like elderly, more mature, more distinguished, okay, individuals, and it is a British brand. But they did come out with a Blue Label version, which is for their younger generation, that was exclusively sold in Japan. But that ended in 2015. They let the license expire in 2016. Now there is a different brand that carries that Blue Label, but it is no longer under Burberry. Okay, so I do have another tote from those, but I don't use it that much. I probably will give it to my mom. The last one that I have here is a beautiful tan pure leather bag, and this is by Christian Dior. So this is an iteration of their saddle bag, except it's not like, it's not weirdly shaped. It's got this handle here, so there you go. What I don't like about this bag though is that it sags like that, but I guess it's the nature of the beast. So it's beautiful, and like, the leather is so freaking soft. I paid, this is also from eBay. What should I pay for this? 360 Australian dollars plus shipping, because this was just here in Australia and I got it really quickly. This has got the serial number 01-RU-0026, and that's what it looks like inside. So beautiful. I usually carry this with an organizer inside, just because I don't like it like getting flimsy and all that, but that's okay. And I got the dust bag right here as well. That was sent to me together with the bag, so I always keep them in a bag. If I don't have a dust bag, I will use a scarf, like I did here with my Burberry. I will use a large scarf to tie them in so that they don't get dusty. Okay, those were the bag category. Now, let's go on to clothing. Two of my favorite jeans ever are thrifted. Okay, this pair here, which I got from Knopf's Op Shop in Newtown, is by the brand Diesel. Okay, if you were a 90s kid, and I think up until now, it's still quite a good brand, but back in the 90s, this was all the rage. Like, I remember being in high school, being a teen, and my classmates were like, oh, I'm wearing Diesel. You know? So, the 90s person in me saw this and I was like, I'm getting that. And then I saw that it was $5 and I was like, I'm definitely getting that. So, that's the one. Anyway, like I said, I'm going to give you a close-up of this. This has got butterflies, so love that. The second pair of jeans I got from Mustard Seed Op Shop, very close to where I live. And this was actually in perfect condition when I got it, so I distressed it myself. And this is a pair of Armani jeans, which I got for $6. Yes, you heard that right. $6 for an Armani jeans and $5 for a pair of Diesel jeans. I mean, how can you go wrong with that? Now, on the pricier side, I do have here a beautiful, beautiful trench coat, and you can probably already tell that it is by Burberry. I got this from U-Turn Vintage in Surrey Hills for $99, and it had a hole in the pocket, which I very easily stitched up. And it says Burberry's, made in England, made expressly for Poitiers, Clermont-Ferrand, I don't know that, but it's obviously been made specifically for a shop or for a person, okay? It's a little bit more oversized on me. It doesn't actually say what size it is, but it feels like it's a size 14, but I do like my trench coats to be, and my coats to be a little bit larger, just because I prefer to put something chunky underneath, and if it's the right size, then it doesn't really serve that purpose, but just it's so beautiful. It's the perfect camel color that I have been looking for. And $99 for a Burberry trench coat that cost normally upwards to $1,000. I'm happy with that. Another coat that I am happy to have found is another Burberry coat. This is made in Poland, UK 10. And it's this beautiful sort of like gray, gray toned coat that can be dressed up or dressed down. I love the metal button there, which is also the same but smaller size buttons on the cuffs. And it's also almost like military inspired, so I'm gonna put in a clip of this, what it looks like. So that's the second one. I got that off of eBay and I paid $70 for it plus shipping, so a total of $85, which isn't bad considering it's Burberry. Now the final one, which I use at work all the time, is this tweed dress with that beautiful, can you see the button detailing on this thing? It's gorgeous. Okay, and it's got sort of like silver threads sewn in. I'll give you another look at this, but yeah, this is by Karl Lagerfeld. Yes, Karl Lagerfeld. And I got this for $20 from the Mustard Seed Op Shop close to where I live in Piermont. And I've been using it at work all the time. And I'll show you, I put it up on Instagram because I used it on my first day of work, and I put it up on Instagram with a blazer and a belt around my waist. And I'll post that on here so you can see what it looks like when worn more formal. And I actually pair that, I believe. Oh no, I paired it with my black shoes. But anyway, I will show you that. So yes, those are my favorite secondhand purchases. Some of them are from eBay or the Facebook Marketplace. A lot of them are from flea markets and thrift shops. So yes, let me know in the comment section down below, do you go secondhand shopping? And if you do, what is your favorite or the best find that you have had when you started doing your secondhand shopping? Okay, let me know in the comment section down below. I'll see you all again in the next video. Bye.